Fundraising. Plate and food sales, liability issues when selling to the public. San Antonio City Ordinance requires all events where food is sold or given away to have a license from Metro Health. In addition, state regulations require inspections of all temporary food service establishments. The regulatory authority may impose additional requirements to protect against health hazards related to the conduct of the temporary food establishment, may prohibit the sale of some or all potentially hazardous foods, and when no health hazard will result, may waive or modify requirements of these rules. When paying for your license from Metro Health, you will be given a notice containing a summary of the terms of the license, including the operational guidelines you must follow to pass inspection on the day of the event. Proof of purchase must be presented at the beginning of the event to the sanitarian inspector. All foods must be from an approved source and/or licensed facility or prepared in the temporary food establishment on site. No homemade cakes, cookies, beans, tacos, or other preparations are permitted to be sold. All other guidelines should be reviewed thoroughly prior to the event date. If cooking is done on site, a fire permit may also be required from the fire marshal. If your event is held in a jurisdiction other than the City of San Antonio, you will need to check with the appropriate licensing office for that area. Complying with these laws will ensure that your event proceeds without interruption while reducing the liability risk associated with selling, serving food items to the public. You should also make sure that event organizers take every precaution possible to eliminate any safety hazards to all volunteers. Tip: student volunteers working plate sales, concessions assignments, and other events that cater to the general public may request documentation of community service hours needed for the National Honor Society. Sales tax. There is a common misconception that tax exemption status is all-encompassing, that is, applying to both sales and use tax that is owed at the time of a purchase and sales and use tax that is due for collection at the time of a sale. It is important to know that your tax-exempt status only applies to sales and use tax that is owed at the time of purchase, and that it only applies to purchases of items necessary in assisting the organization to achieve its tax-exempt purpose. Purchases of personal items or any goods or services that don't directly meet that requirement are not qualified tax-exempt transactions. You must keep those transactions separate from the club's tax-exempt transactions. Any individual claiming tax exemption fraudulently is subject to fines and possible criminal charges. Booster officers and members would also be subject to the same penalties if they authorize any individual to falsely claim a tax exemption. Since there is no exemption for the collection of sales and use tax, exempt organizations must get a sales tax permit and collect and remit sales tax for all taxable items it sells. It is the responsibility of the organization to collect correctly calculated sales tax on taxable goods and services it sells, then report those to the state at the appropriate interval determined by the total gross receipts. However, there are exceptions that allow sales tax collection and reporting to be avoided. It is highly recommended that your booster club limits its sales activities to situations that are covered by these exceptions, thus avoiding the need to obtain a sales tax permit and comply with the otherwise required reporting. The Texas Comptroller Public Accounts brochure, titled Exempt Organizations, Sales and Purchases, outlines the exceptions as follows. Tax-free sales fundraisers. An organization does not have to register for a sales tax permit if all its sales are of exempt items or sales made through tax-free fundraisers. Meals and food products. Exempt organizations do not have to collect sales tax on meals and food products, including candy and soft drinks, if the items are sold or served by a public or private school, school district, student organization, or parent-teacher association in an elementary or secondary school during the regular school day by agreement with proper school authorities, including vending machine sales or sold by a member or volunteer of a nonprofit organization devoted exclusively to education or to physical or religious training, or by a group associated with private or public elementary and secondary schools as part of an organization's fundraising drive, when all net proceeds from the sale go to the organization for its exclusive use. Note: alcoholic beverages are taxable. Sales of alcoholic beverages made by the holder of a mixed beverage permit are subject to the 14% mixed beverage gross receipts tax. Sales of beer and wine made by the holder of a beer and wine only permit are subject to sales tax. Annual banquets and suppers. All volunteer organizations can hold a tax-free annual banquet or other food sale, provided the event is not professionally catered, is not held in a restaurant, hotel, or similar place of business, is not in competition with a retailer required to collect tax, and the food is prepared, served, and sold by members of the organization. Note: the exemption does not apply to the sale of alcoholic beverages. Auctions, rummage sales, and other fundraisers. Each chapter of an exempt organization under IRS 501c3 can hold 2 one-day tax-free sales or auctions each calendar year, January through December. One-day sales. For one-day sales, exempt organizations are not required to collect sales tax. This exemption does not apply to items sold for more than $5,000, unless the item is manufactured by the organization or the item is donated to the organization and not sold back to the donor. For purposes of the exemption, one day is counted as 24 consecutive hours. These days should be pre-designated so purchasers are aware of the tax exemptions. Organizations are prohibited from collecting and keeping taxes on these transactions. The designated one-day tax-free sale day is either the day the vendor delivers the items to the exempt organization or the day the organization delivers the items to its customers. Persons buying from surplus inventory on the designated date do not owe tax. For example, a church group selling cookbooks may accept pre-orders without collecting tax if the day the cookbooks will be delivered to the customers is designated as one of the group's tax-free fundraisers. Surplus cookbooks sold during the same day also qualify for the exemption. Surplus cookbooks sold on other days are taxable unless sold at the group's other tax-free fundraiser. If two or more groups together hold a one-day tax-free sale, the event counts as one tax-free sale for each participating organization. If an exempt organization is purchasing taxable items for resale during its designated tax-free sale days, and it holds a sales tax permit, the organization may either give the retailer a resale certificate, the front of Form 01339, or an exemption certificate, the back of Form 01339, to purchase the items tax-free. A non-permitted exempt organization, however, may purchase items for resale tax-free by issuing an exemption certificate to the vendor for its items sold during its 2 one-day tax-free sales. Non-qualifying fundraisers. Acting as an agent or sales representative. When engaging in fundraising activities, an exempt organization needs to identify the seller of the taxable items in order to determine responsibility for collecting tax. In some fundraising activities, an exempt organization will enter into a contract with a private for-profit entity to sell taxable items. For example, a group may receive a commission for holding a book fair or for selling candy, gift wrap, or similar items, or the group will be provided with sales brochures and take orders for fulfillment by the for-profit entity. The exempt entity may collect the funds and remit an agreed portion to the for-profit entity. In these cases, the fundraising firm is considered the seller and is responsible for collecting collection of applicable sales and use taxes. Exempt organizations are not responsible for sales taxes and does not use one of the organization's tax-free sales days for the fundraiser. May fundraising companies include sales tax due in the selling price of items? This practice is acceptable when the for-profit company discloses on the invoices or order brochures that Texas sales tax is included in the sales price. This allows the company to remit to the state any due sales taxes. In this instance, the exempt organization is not required to collect any tax amount over the sales price. Amusement services. The sale of an amusement service provided exclusively by an exempt organization other than an IRS Section 501c7 organization is exempt from sales tax as long as the proceeds do not benefit an individual. For example, the sale of a ticket to a school carnival, dance, athletic event, or musical concert is exempt. For an event to qualify for an exemption, the organization must distinguish itself as the sole provider in advertising. For example, billboards, radio, television, and other media promoting the event, as well as on the face of the physical tickets. Tickets should reflect that the exempt organization is the provider and that the event is exempt from Texas sales and use tax. Can a nonprofit organization hire a for-profit entity? A nonprofit organization is allowed to hire a for-profit entity to supply expertise required to produce an event as long as the for-profit entity is not also considered a provider of the amusement service. Nonprofit groups' membership dues and fees are tax exempt. Country clubs and similar organizations that provide amusement services do not qualify for this exemption. Publications. Publications and writings are tax exempt if published and distributed by a religious, philanthropic, charitable, historical, scientific, or IRS 501c3 organization. Materials published by educational organizations do not qualify for this exemption. Boosters should review the exempt organization sales and purchases brochure for more detailed information. Accepting credit card transactions online and mobile. As mentioned earlier, Intuit and Wave both offer credit and debit card processing services at an additional cost. Those services can be purchased or enabled from within their respective products, but there are also other low-cost solutions available with the added benefit of mobile processing. Square provides free mobile apps for iPhone, iPad, and Android phones and tablets that enable you to process credit debit cards while mobile. There's no complicated application process and monthly service fees and other charges related to merchant services provided by a bank. No setup fees, no requirement to purchase or lease physical card readers, and no need to pay additional costs for receipt paper or dedicated phone lines. Even the mobile card reader is free, and you can always request additional readers at no charge. Compatible devices with the Square app installed become mobile point-of-sale systems, where you can even save information on regularly sold items and donation amounts, run the credit debit card, and even have the customer sign with their finger or stylus and receive a receipt via email or text message. You can also access your account and review your transactions history and other information right from the mobile app. Nonprofits can use the mobile staff feature to invite volunteers and staff to process transactions on the club's behalf without allowing them to view sensitive account information. You can even customize your receipts and save your employer identification number to ensure that IRS reporting is associated with the organization rather than the individual who created the account. The only cost of using Square is the low transaction fee of 2.75% for swiped transactions and 3.5% plus 15 cents for manually entered transactions. Unlike Square, which is purely a mobile solution, PayPal offers full merchant services for your organization. You can accept credit debit card payments on your website, including payments for spirit items, parent polo shirts, event registrations, and charitable donations. PayPal now has a mobile solution called PayPal Here, with most of the same features provided by Square. PayPal Here turns any compatible iPhone, iPad, or Android phone into a mobile register. It's not a complete mobile POS system like Square, but it does everything a Booster Club needs to accept credit debit card payments at any remote location. Like Square, you can enable volunteers and staff to process transactions on behalf of your club without accessing other account information, but you must set up additional user accounts on the PayPal website. You can also download other PayPal mobile apps that allow you to calculate PayPal fees in advance, access your transaction history, and even transfer funds to your club's bank account. The PayPal website also allows you to do all this and more, like create custom Buy Now buttons for your website. If you already have a PayPal account, signing up for PayPal Here is a snap, and they'll mail you your free mobile card reader. You can call customer support to request additional card readers, or you can pick them up at Staples for $15 each. They'll provide you with a mail-in rebate for you to receive a full reimbursement from PayPal. New PayPal business accounts can be created on their website fairly easily. You will need to provide your bank account information along with your business employer identification number and other information. If you provide your 501c3 documentation as well, you'll be able to take advantage of a special discount pricing on your transaction fees. PayPal's transaction fees are normally 2.9% plus 30 cents, and PayPal here charges 2.7% per transaction, 3.5% plus 15 cents for manually entered transactions. For nonprofits, PayPal fees are discounted down to 2.2% plus 30 cents, while PayPal here charges remain the same. PayPal also provides live phone support and the ability to accept checks and direct payments from other PayPal account users. Your PayPal account functions just like any commercial bank account. You can make PayPal payments to vendors and individuals with PayPal accounts of their own, send payments or invoices via email, and transfer funds to and from your actual bank account, which also acts as backup funding for your PayPal account. For example, if you use your PayPal account to make a $100 payment to a screen printing service and there is only $75 available in your PayPal account, PayPal will automatically draw $25 from your bank account to complete the transaction. Like regular bank accounts, you can download your transaction history and import it into QuickBooks, Wave, GNU Cash, etc. If your club's financial policy allows for the use of charge cards, you can also apply for a PayPal debit card that allows you to charge payments or withdraw funds from an ATM. That financial policy should include appropriate safeguards to prevent fraudulent use. The ability to accept credit debit card payments online and on-site is an easy way to increase revenue without incurring any additional costs. You can add convenience, processing, or handling charges to your prices to cover transaction fees, thus passing on that cost to your customers. You don't have to pay all the additional charges related to merchant services provided by traditional banks, and there are no credit checks or complicated applications required. No more missing out on sales because potential customers do not have cash on them, and no more lost revenue on silent auction items because customers aren't carrying enough cash to surpass the previous bidder. Also, more and more vendors are accepting payments online and do not process checks.